The if function is used to perform conditional evaluations within expressions. It allows you to define conditions and specify what action or value should be returned based on whether the condition evaluates to true or false. The if syntax is composed of the following components: the if function, the condition, expression that is interpreted logically, then expression. Expression can be of any type. If the condition is true, then the if function returns the value of the then expression. Else expression. Expression can be of any type. If the condition is false, then the if function returns the value of the else expression. This parameter is optional. If the condition is false, null is returned if you have not specified else. In this example, we have a table with a column for customer and a column for sales. Our goal is to add a third column that categorizes sales into high if the sales amount is greater than 1,000, and low otherwise. To achieve this, we define the expression in the expression editor. Now, for each row of data, the field will contain either high or low, based on the value of the sales field. The if function in Qlik can also be nested, allowing for more complex conditional logic. In this case, if the sales is greater than 1,000, it's categorized as high. If it's between 501 and 1,000, it's categorized as medium. And if it's 500 or less, it's categorized as low. The if function can be used for various purposes. For example, you can use it in the text color expression to conditionally color your measures. In this case, we're going to create an expression to conditionally assign RGB color codes based on the value of the sum of sales. If the sum of sales is greater than 1,000, it returns green. If the sum of sales is less than or equal to 1,000, but individual sales are greater than 500, it returns blue. Otherwise, it returns red. Similar to other chart functions, you can use the if function in combination with other functions. In this example, we're going to show how to use it with the rank function. So we're going to use an expression to label data points based on their rank of the total sum of sales. The column will show the label top sellers if their sum of sales ranks within the top 10. Otherwise, the row will be blank. As you can see, in this column, only the top sellers will be labeled. And that concludes this video. Thanks for watching.